Hello students, welcome to LFI Educates. So in this video we shall discuss about the seventh chapter, that is integrals. So we shall learn in detail about the integral formulas and where we can use the integration. So basically there are two types of integrals. One is indefinite integration or indefinite, and another is definite integration. So in indefinite and definite, what we do? Indefinite, two boundaries are given, basically a and b, and we need to find the integration inside that limit. So in definite, what happens is that a curve is given and two boundaries are given, and we need to find the area, or we can find the area using the integration, okay, inside the enclosed by the boundary as well as the curve. And in indefinite, what we do, in our previous chapters we have found the derivative of a function, isn't it? And that was equal to f dash x, that is ddx of fx is equal to f dash x. So in indefinite integral, what we do is that we find this function. This function is called the primitive. We find this function. Like, the question is like that: if we are able to find the derivative of this fx and we are getting it as f dash x, so what will be the antiderivative of f dash x? It will be fx, isn't it? So using the indefinite integrals or indefinite integration, we are able to find this fx. Fine. So for example, let us take let the function fx be sin x. Okay. Then what will be ddx of sin x, or what will be f dash x? It will be cos x, right? So we know from the definition of our derivatives that we can sin x is cos x, okay? We can find the derivative of sin x, that is cos x. Now let's say a function is given, fx is equal to cos x. Now what is the antiderivative of cos x? How to find? In that case we use the integration. So since the derivative of sin x is cos x, so we can say that the antiderivative of cos x is sin x. That is, we represent it like this: integration of f dash x dx will be sin x. Okay, now we shall come to this part later, the integration one. So before that, let us see one more thing. Here we have fx is equal to sin x. Now what about this fx? If fx is a constant, and that is equal to, let us assume c, then what will be f dash x? F dash x means what? Ddx of f of x. So what will be that? That will be 0, isn't it? So in place of this, or in here, I can write ddx of sin x is cos x, isn't it? Because f dash x means ddx of f dash x and fx, and that is sin x. Now here I can add one more thing, not giving implies. Like from there I can write ddx of sin x plus c. That will be what? By the algebra of derivatives, we know that if two functions are in addition form, so we have to define the derivative of sin x first and then the derivative of c. So the derivative of sin x is cos x, and what is the derivative of c? It is 0. So this part will be, the answer will be cos x. Now clearly we can see that the derivative of sin x and the derivative of sin x plus c, both are cos x. Okay, so one thing is clear, that the antiderivative, this is called the antiderivative of cos x, isn't it? These two are called the antiderivatives of cos x. So one thing is clear, that two function may have the same derivative, but a particular derivative may not have the same antiderivative. Okay, so that means if I add here one, sin x plus 1, this is also a function. Sin x plus 2, this is also another function. Sin x plus 100, this is also another function. So we can have infinitely many functions whose derivative is cos x. Okay, but if we want to find the antiderivative, ऑफ कॉस एक्स वी शैल गेट ए फैमिली ऑफ एंटी डेरिवेटिव्स. सो व्हाट इज दैट फैमिली बेसिकली? नाउ लेट अस जनरलाइज दिस. इफ वी हैव ए फंक्शन एफ एक्स देन द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ एफ एक्स लेट अस डिनोटेड बाय कैपिटल एफ एक्स. ओके ऑल्सो फ्रॉम देयर व्हाट वी कैन वी राइट डी डी एक्स ऑफ एफ एक्स प्लस सी विल बी व्हाट विल बी द एफ एक्स अगेन विल बी सेम थिंग. सो वी कैन से दैट दिस एफ एक्स प्लस सी इज द एंटी डेरिवेटिव और दीज आर द फैमिली ऑफ एंटी डेरिवेटिव्स ऑफ द फंक्शन एफ एक्स कैपिटल एफ एक्स. ओके नाउ सिंस वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द एंटी डेरिवेटिव्स लेट अस इंट्रोड्यूस द सिंबल ऑफ एंटी डेरिवेटिव और इन अदर वर्ड्स एंटी डेरिवेटिव्स दीज आर ऑल्सो नोन एज इंटीग्रेशन. द प्रोसेस इज नोन एज द इंटीग्रेशन और इंटीग्रल्स. ओके नाउ वी शैल सी व्हाट आर इंटीग्रल्स व्हाट इंटीग्रेशन व्हाट इज इंटीग्रेंड. सो दिस एंटी डेरिवेटिव दिस कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड लाइक दिस इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ एफ एक्स दैट मीन्स वी आर इंटीग्रेटिंग दिस एफ एक्स नाउ टू गेट द एंटी डेरिवेटिव with respect to x and that will be fx plus c. Fine. And what is the name of the c? This is called the integrating constant or sometimes we call as constant of integration this c. Okay. So I hope now it is clear why we are using this c, because the integration of a function is a family of functions, not a single function. Okay, all right. Now coming to this, or we can represent it something else, like we can write integration of g of x dx is equal to capital G of x plus c. I'm just changing the variables, the name of the functions, the concept is same. So what is this? This is called the integral. This gx is called the integrand and this x represents that we are going to integrate this function with respect to x. Okay, and this c is called the constant of integration or the integrating constant. Now another meaning of integration you can see from this is that what is the relation of derivative and integration. See, in derivative we have find out the rate of change, isn't it? That means in other words we say that using derivative we break a function and using integration we add a function, or we integrate all the small parts that has been distributed by the derivative and we get the previous function. Okay, all right, so that is all about integration. And now let us see a few properties of integration. So what are the properties we have? See, earlier you have got the derivatives. So the first one you have got ddx of x to the power n. What was it? It was n x to the power n minus 1. So what would be the integration of n x to the power n minus 1? It will be x to the power n plus c, where c is the integrating constant. Okay, so you might ask why it is not the same. So I have told you earlier that whenever we integrate a function we do not get the exact function, we get the family of that function. Okay, now using the same thing let us see another one, ddx of x to the power n plus 1 by n plus 1. What about this? What is that is equal to? You see, here n plus 1 is constant, 1 by n plus 1, and ddx of x to the power n plus 1 is n plus 1 into x to the power n plus 1 minus 1, so that will be n. Now if I cancel these two, we shall get x to the power n. Now since ddx of x to the power n plus 1 by x n plus 1 is equal to x to the power n, so what will be the integration? Integration of x to the power n, okay, sorry, with respect to dx. This is very important, okay? This x will represent that we are integration, we are integrating the function of x. So that will be equal to this, that is x to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus c. Now actually this is the most important formula. Whatever we shall use something that is substitution method and many other, there we shall be using this particular formula only. So one consequence to that is that if x to the power, let's say ddx of x, what is that, is equal to 1. Now integration of 1 dx is equal to what, x plus c. The same thing, because x to the power 0 if we put here, that will be 1, and the thing will be x to the power 0 plus 1 will be 1, and here it will be 0 plus 1 will be 1, so it will be x only. Okay, so this can be represented as, if we do not write 1 also, suppose only the integration sign is there along with the dx, then also the answer will be same. Okay, and so similarly we can find all the powers of x to the power n, like if the power is x square, if the power is x to the power half, if the power is x to the power minus 3/2, everything will follow this rule or this formula. Okay, next we have the trigonometric one. Let's say d dx of sine x is cos x. Now what is that? Integration of cos x will be sin x plus c. Here it is a dx, okay. Then 5, d dx of cos x is what? Minus sin x. So integration of sin x dx will be minus cos x. Minus is coming from here. Okay. Similarly, we can find all the other trigonometric ratios. Trigonometric integration of the trigonometric functions. And now let us see the inverse one. Number 6, let us see d dx of sine inverse x. What is that? 1 by root over 1 minus x squared. So integration will be integration of 1 by root over 1 minus x squared dx will be sine inverse x plus c. So the things are same, the concept is same, only we are getting a plus c here along with the function. Okay, so other things are almost everything is same, like the I've given you the formulas in the chapter of differentiation. So just write the opposite thing, or just write the antiderivative of the functions and you will get the integrals. Okay, so before starting the problems, let us see a few properties of integration. So number one, we have d dx of integration of the function fx with respect to x is equal to fx. Why? We can see that, or we can informally say that this derivative and the integration cancels each other and we're getting the same function. Okay, and other is that integration of derivative of fx dx will give us fx plus c, where c is the constant of integration. Now why there is a c and why there is not a c? See, here we can see that after the integration is taking place, then we are differentiating it. So whatever plus c will come here, it will vanish. Okay, but since here in this case, at first we are differentiating and then we are integrating, so because of the integration at the final moment, we are getting a c here. Okay, now let us see another one, that is addition. So integration of fx plus gx, so this dx is very important. Okay, the integration will depend on this x. If it is, okay, I'll tell you later. Now what is that? That will be equal to integration of fx dx plus integration of gx dx. Now number 3, integration of k fx dx. Now what is this k? This k is any scalar or any constant. So in this case, what will happen? This k will come out and we shall be integrating only the fx with respect to dx. Okay, Now, from this two, 2 and 3, we can write a formula, or we can get a thing that is, if integration, we have a function, integration of k1 fx plus k2, or integrate k1 f1x plus k2 f2x plus k3 f3x and so on. If you want to integrate this function with respect to dx, then what will be the result? Using both of this, from the from question, from property 2, what can we see? If it is in the addition form, just break it. So we shall break them individually. And from 3, we can see if there is a constant, take the constant out. So our result will be k1 integration of f1x dx plus k2 integration of f2x dx and so on. So basically, in our while doing the problems, we shall be using this property 4. Okay, now one thing I was saying that here, if I have a function integration of fx dx, then clearly we can find the integrate, or we can integrate it, isn't it? That will be something fx plus c. Now what if it is integration of fx and here it is dy, then what? At that time this fx will behave as a constant, because this is a function of x but we are integrating with respect to y. So we shall write the fx here, and this integration of dy will be only y plus c. Okay, because we know the integration of dx is x plus c, so integration of dy, this fx will act as a constant. Similarly, integration of say fy dx, what will happen here? The same thing, this is a function of x, and so this we are integrating with respect to x, and this is a function of y. So fy will come out, and integration of dx will be x along with the c. Okay, so these are a few properties of integration, and now let us see a few problems from the exercise 7.1. So the first one, let us see question number 3. Here it is given. Okay, question number 2, cos of 3x. Find an antiderivative of the following functions by method of inspection. Now what is method of inspection? Inspection means there is no basic hard and fast rule for that. We just try, this is called, also called the trial and failure method, or we can just try it for what value of like the dx. So for what value of fx we are getting cos of 3x. So let us put a few things here, and then we shall see whether we're getting the cos 3x or not. So basically we have to find the antiderivative, that means we have to find the fx. Now when do we get cos 3x? That is the question. So we have seen that ddx of sine 3x, that is equal to what? Cos of 3 cos 3x, isn't it? Now this implies I can write cos of 3x is equal to 1 by 3 sine of 3x, sorry, 1 by 3 ddx of sine of 3x. Now this is equal to, I can write, since 1 by 3 is a constant, I can take it inside also. So this will be equal to ddx of 1 by 3 sine 3x. So what we are getting, ddx of 1 by 3 sine 3x is cos 3x. So by inspection, what you have got, fx must be equal to 1 by 3 sine 3x. So in words, we can write 1 by 3 sine 3x is the antiderivative of cos 3x. Very easy. Okay. Now, let us see question number 6. So in question number 6, quite easy, integration of 4e to the power thrice x plus 1 dx. Now see, so we have to recall the formulas whatever we have studied. Now this integration is in the form of what? Fx plus gx into with respect to x. We have to integrate it with respect to x. So by the property 2, what can we write? 4 e to the power thrice x dx plus 1 dx. And what that will be equal to? I can take out the 4 because this is a scalar. So integration of thrice x dx plus integration of dx, because 1 we can just omit it. Now integration of e to the power 3x. Now what is that? What was the derivative? E to the power 3x. What was the derivative? It was 3 e to the power 3x, isn't it? Now what will be the integration of e to the power 3x? It will be 1 by 3 e to the power thrice x. So it will be e to the power thrice x by 3. And here it will be x only. Integration of dx will be x. Now one question arises is that I have told you that for every integration there will be a plus c. So even for this integration we have a plus c, isn't it? So yes, you can give a plus c here, you can give a plus c here, and at last you can write it e to the power thrice x by 3 plus x plus 2c. This is also a constant, because as we do not know what is c, so we can write anything here. And finally we can write 4 e to the power thrice x by 3 plus x plus c dash or a, b, c, anything. Now since it is a small problem, so we have I have written here like this, but in general what we do is that whenever the integration is done, we simply write a plus c here. This will mean that whatever c or whatever constants we are taking the final constant after adding up or subtracting everything. Okay, so it is enough to write the plus c at last. All right, okay, now let us see another problem. Now let us see question number 13. Here it is given integration of x cubed minus x square plus x minus 1 divided by x minus 1. So we do not have any formula of finding the integration when it is in a rational form or in a p by q form. So what to do? We need to omit this denominator. So for that, what can we do? Just take x square common, so we shall have x minus 1 plus x minus 1 divided by x minus 1 dx. So in the next term, what will happen? All the x minus 1 will cancel, so we shall be remaining with x square plus 1 only into dx. Now that is much easier. So integration of x square dx plus integration of dx, that will give us what is integration of x to the power n? Integration of x to the power n is into dx, and this is what? X to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. So here we shall have 2 plus 1 will be 3 and divided by 3 plus x, and at last plus c. Okay, so this will be the answer. Now let us see question number 17. So what does question number 17 say? Integration of twice x square minus thrice x plus 5 root x dx. Okay, so what to do here? Integration of, since this is in the form fx plus gx plus hx, so write them separately first. 2x square dx minus integration of 3x dx plus integration of 5 root x dx. Now what is that? You can bring out the two scalar outside, so it will be integration of x square dx minus, take the 3 outside, 3x dx plus 5 integration of, and this will be 1 by 2 dx. Root x means x to the power 1 by 2, isn't it? So that will be equal to 2 into x cube by 3 minus 3 into x squared by 2 plus 5 into x to the power minus x to the power 1 by 2 plus 1, that will be 3 by 2, and down it will be 3 by 2. So once the integration is done, write the c. So we shall have 2 by 3 x cube minus 3 by 2 x squared plus this 5 to 10 by 3 x to the power 3 by 2 plus c. So this is how we do integration, and integration is such type of problem, it totally bases on the of your practice, okay. So the more you practice, the more you'll be confident in integration. So it's all about practice. There will be, we shall be getting many more formulas and how to solve different kind of integration problems. So this will be the end of this video.